This video, how to tell if your potassium is too high or too low, how to manage potassium levels and how to use potassium to balance sodium levels. And I'm super excited to present you this video because really a lot of people are asking me, hey Catherine, am I getting too much potassium or maybe too little potassium and how can I tell? Don't worry, I'm here to make things as easy and comprehensible as possible and to give you all the answers you need. Hello, how are your kidneys doing? This is Catherine. Welcome to 00 Kidney. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Most kidney patients have either too low potassium or too high potassium, and this is absolutely not their fault. When chronic kidney disease is present or there is a kidney damage of any kind, including acute kidney failure, the chances of having the wrong potassium levels are very high and very dangerous. This depends on a lot of factors like GFR, diet, and if you are on dialysis. And if you have already been googling about how to lower potassium levels and what foods are good for renal diet, etc., you may already know that there are a lot of sites and video talking about this topic. But there is also a lot of misinformation and a lot of those how-to guides are not entirely suitable for kidney patients. This is because this topic is complicated and depending on the stage of kidney disease, you may be prone to hyperkalemia, meaning too much potassium, or hypokalemia, too little potassium. But don't worry, in the next few minutes I'll clear things up and you'll see that getting the correct amount of potassium in your diet will be easy and beneficial for the health of your kidneys. The first thing to get right is that not everyone with kidney problems needs to reduce their potassium levels. There's in fact a chance that you need to get more of it. Potassium is very important. It's an essential mineral. Essential means that the body cannot synthesize it by its own and it needs it from foods. Potassium is also an electrolyte, meaning that the body uses it to conduct the electricity needed for several vital functions like nerve signals and muscle contraction, including those of the heart. This means that a severe imbalance in the potassium levels can even cause the heart to stop. More on how to prevent this in a moment. Potassium is also what regulates the intracellular fluid balance of the body. The body needs a perfect balance of fluids, potassium and sodium to function. This balance can also affect the health of the kidneys. A lot of people eat too much sodium and too little potassium. This is very common since healthy foods are rich in potassium, while junk foods and processed foods are full of salt and sodium. So, if you have low levels of potassium, very healthy foods rich in potassium that you can add to your diet include spinaches, potatoes and sweet potatoes, oranges, kiwis, bananas and dark chocolate. Now, kidney patients are often told to limit the potassium intake, but this is only helpful when the kidneys are not working enough to filter the potassium from the blood and the person is still not on dialysis. Usually, people with CKD, chronic kidney disease, up to stage 3 and GFR above 40 or 50, are still able to get rid of the excess of potassium through their kidneys. GFR means glomeruli filtration rate and tells us in percentage how much our kidneys are working. So, when the kidneys are still working at 40 or 50%, the potassium is usually still filtered well enough. Unfortunately, GFR numbers can fluctuate and potassium levels can go up or down in a short amount of time. So, if you have any doubts, get checked for your potassium levels. Patients in advanced stages of chronic kidney disease are always on a low potassium diet. Usually, it's your doctor that will tell you when to start managing your diet to reduce potassium intake. Unfortunately, we all know that this is not always the case and a lot of people have to schedule their tests by their own and to study their diets all by themselves. Now, what I usually tell people is to listen to their body and to gradually take steps to become healthier. But I'm also strongly recommending you to get checked regularly, especially for potassium levels. This is because the symptoms of hyperkalemia, levels of potassium too high, can be really dangerous, especially for kidney patients. In the advanced stages of CKD, stage 4 and 5, the kidneys can no longer remove excess potassium from the blood. Symptoms of hyperkalemia include fatigue, nausea, vomiting, chest pain, trouble breathing, and a feeling of numbness or tingling. Now, most of these symptoms are to be expected in stage 4 or 5, so they are not enough to tell that there is a problem with potassium. This is why getting checked is important. But there are other symptoms only present when the potassium levels are starting to become dangerous. Palpitations, irregular heartbeat, and even heart failure and heart attack. So if you need to keep in check the levels of potassium, there are some foods that you should absolutely avoid. First of all, there are processed foods. FDA regulations do not require food producers to label potassium levels, so canned and processed foods are usually full of sodium too. Just avoid them. Salt substitutes are also full of potassium. Also avoid orange juice and other juices, tomatoes, spinach, potatoes, etc. There are also other foods. In a moment, I'll show you the full list on the screen. There's a link in the description to the full list. It's on newhopeforkidneypatients.com, our website. You can download it from there, so you can consult it when you need it. This is all for today. If you like this video, please like and leave a comment. Thank you.